What up, world? It's your boy Amp Dog with another episode of Politicking. Want to thank everybody for tuning in, showing your love, and make sure you tell a friend to tell a friend. Big Amp Dog said, what's the deal? And today, we about to talk about Miss Rachel Nichols and some leaked audio. I want to play that audio before I get my little response or my take on it. my take might be a little different than everybody else's. But we'll see. Let's see if we can get this queued up. Let's see.
So they said to me, hey, instead of hosting the NBA Finals, like, why don't you do Doris and Skylar reporter job for the NBA Finals? Because guess what that would clear the way for? For Maria to do the hosting.
Yeah.
So, I have declined. I don't know what their next move is, but they are feeling pressure because of all of that, and I'm trying to figure out like how to just, you know, my thing is that I wish Maria Taylor all the success in the world. She covers football, she covers basketball. If you need to give her more things to do because you're feeling pressure about your like crappy long time record on diversity, which by the way I myself like know personally from the female side of it, like go for it. Just, you know, find it somewhere else. Like, you're not gonna find it with me and taking my thing away.
Well, I would sure say, well, Rach, you sure as hell ain't no Doris Burke. The hell? But anyway, I mean, don't get me wrong. How could I? Let me digest this 1 second. Woosah. All right, so look, this is how I really feel. I'm not, it's understandable. You mad that your position gone. But like most people, when you mad, and it's like little kids, right? Let's say they want a lollipop, but they ain't ate their dinner yet. So you take the lollipop and you say you eat the dinner later. And so instead of them just saying, you know what, let me eat this dinner so I can get my lollipop quicker, they just say, man, fuck this dinner and throw the food everywhere. So to me, that's kind of like what Rachel was doing. Like, so yeah, you're bothered. Of course, you don't want your job. You don't want to change positions or whatever, however it go. But what I heard was your response as far as why you declined was because of who that would make an opening for, or who would that clear an opening for, you know, which would be Maria. Now that's, it's competitive. Y'all in the sports world. So I get it. Y'all super competitive and want to be the best, and you want to be on every single segment and this and that, which is fine. That's fine. But when you tap into the racism of it all, the fact that they're giving this talented young lady, who has, by the way, been kind of on the up and up, like for the last few years, I would say. Anyway, she's been on a rise, and you know how it is. Like they be saying, the old school be hating on the new rappers. You know what I'm saying? So you see some new fresh in here with a little bit more swag, a little bit pizzazz, and you hating. And it's understandable because it is your job. But the thing is it's not like they told you, like what they do to most black people is they had your ass train that motherfucker to take your position. And then they get you the fuck out the company. It's not like you can go over to this section. All right, so you go from doing what you're doing here, but then we're going to put you over here. We're going to let her have this right here. Like they gave you an option and you declined it because you didn't want to lose out to a black woman. And maybe I am assuming that, but your words say a lot. It said a lot. You know what I'm saying? And all these motherfuckers that's going on capping, trying to, like, Steven Jackson or whatever his name is, Steven Jackass, you go in there trying to super ride for Maria, and then shout out to Kwame Brown, because now I'm really thinking about it. None of this shit probably would never have happened if Kwame Brown didn't come just shake up the whole infrastructure of this whole get along, go along game. Shout out to Kwame Brown, man. He the one who really got ESPN shook up over there, because all these players that they try to protect, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, we gotta give big up to him, because he the real reason why I feel like all of this stuff is starting. Like he didn't found a little chink in the armor, and now you know you're starting to see everybody just they desperate, they moving around, scrambling around, trying to figure out some stuff. But you know, I do want to also give her props, because what she did say about the shitty diversity at ESPN, we all know that. And yeah, you could go through whatever she said. She said she could relate because she's been on that side of diversity, I guess, where coming from a woman's perspective. But I don't ever think that it's possible, because yeah, in a male dominated thing, yeah, a woman would be the minority, or would, you know, get the back end of certain things, right? I mean, it still happens in a lot of other industries too, but the reality is, to me, that was like a weak-ass cop-out, because you knew that you really was fueled by the fact that this black woman was about to get put in a position that you wanted. You know what I'm saying? And then what you do to try to combat it is what everybody do. They smack you in the face and then they ask you for a hug. You know what I'm saying? It's just this, like, back and forth. You know what I'm saying? And that's basically what you did. You try to do a little bit of damage control in that conversation. And I don't know why LeBron James' spokesperson is even the one that you feel comfortable of talking to like that. I haven't heard Bron say anything about it either, but I'm sure more will come out. But yeah, my whole take on it is, Rachel, yeah, you dropped the ball on this one. I feel like you hating, you big hating, not a little hating, but big hating. Like, and then you expose a lot of things that you said within that small little clip. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, they trying to give her this job because of her diversity. You know what? It's crazy, because I remember like growing up trying to get jobs and stuff, and it would be a fact of my race and my skin tone that I wouldn't get jobs a lot of times. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't. I would get beat out by the more clean-cut, preppy white boy. You know what I'm saying? Or even Hispanic and Asian. You know what I'm saying? So at this point, it's like, I feel you, because right is right, wrong is wrong. But at the same time, y'all got to stop complaining about shit that y'all going through, that black people we've been sustaining this shit. We've been sustaining this shit. Like, come on, Rach, you should have known eventually a young, beautiful black woman was going to take your position. It was bound to happen. It ain't got nothing to do with no fucking race baiting, trying to diversify shit. That ain't got nothing to do with it. You know why? Because black is beautiful. No, I didn't mean to say that. Black sells, though. I'll be real. You know what I'm saying? Like, who's more influential than the black culture? And that's just what it is. But black is beautiful. I didn't mean to say I'm just playing after that. But, yeah. Everybody going on these goddamn racist rants. I'm about to have one. God damn it. But anyway, y'all let me know what y'all think about this. Like, share, subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Big Am Dog said, what's the deal? Drop y'all comments down below on this one. I really want to know. Do y'all think I'm tripping? You know what I'm saying? Because I really got a whole lot more that I want to talk about with this shit. But I'm going to just keep it small and keep it simple. You know what I'm saying? We might do a live show, take live calls or something just to really, you know, get into it. But yeah, hey, man, y'all have a beautiful day. I'ma holler at y'all. And protect your family, protect yourself, and protect your peace.